It's time for the expert segment. Last week, we started a conversation with a legal expert on due diligence before signing the dotted line. Let's catch up with Esther on a watertight contract and the procedure of buying a project off plan. Extra caution should we take as the buyer? Because I'm finding day in, day out, people are paying to agents or to people purporting to be the owners of the property and losing money.
So as I said, you do your diligence, ensure that you've signed the good contract in place.
What is good contract?
What is a good contract?
Yes.
A good contract is one that safeguards the interests of a buyer. And one of the things it does is that it will stipulate how the money will be held. For example, it should stipulate no funds will be released to the seller. It should have provisions for a completion date. For example, if you sign a contract and it's open-ended, you don't know when the house will be ready or when you'll take possession of the house, that's not a good contract. It should have a completion date. It should also have a clause on events of default. Yeah. If the vendor defaults, what is it that you should expect to get from there? Is it a refund of your money plus interest perhaps? Or what is it that you should expect to get?
And if he delays, what would happen to you?
Typically what happens is if there is a delay on either party, there should be a clause on payment of interest. Yeah. And the typical applicable rate would be current lending rate. So ensure there's an interest cost clause in there that then enables you to recover your money plus interest for the lost time. Yeah. So the challenge is to negotiate a tight contract that ensures that your money
and
is
that's
safe.
Why it's important to get yourself a lawyer.
Absolutely, I agree.
And at what point do I know that the transaction is completed?
That would be at the point when the transfer has been registered in favor of you as a buyer and when you have been given title to the land. Now, title to the land is a physical document and it takes different forms. It could be a long-term lease, it could be a freehold title, it could take different forms, and if you go to your lawyer, he'll be able to explain whether that's a good title or not. The other thing is that possession of the property should be handed over to you. Yeah,
because so we should physically go to the site.
Yes, and get physical possession of the property. If it's a plot, then what you need to do at that point is to be shown the beacons of the property and even get a beacon certificate relating to that plot. If it's a house, then you need to even inspect the house, confirm that the fittings and the fixtures are proper.
And it's what you had agreed?
That's right, yeah. Well, what you had agreed to buy and then take it over from there. Probably I could add something else regarding off-plan buy.
Yes.
Now, off-plan buying, I think, is one of the most challenging sort of transactions that one would get into. Why? Because when you go to the physical site, you may not find a house or you will not find a house. And what the seller ordinarily has is a set of plans. Yeah. So as a clever buyer, what you then do is look at the plans, confirm that indeed they represent the sort of property that you would be looking to buy in terms of the size of the house and perhaps the way it is designed. Then, look at the elevations and see that in terms of the physical appearance of the property, it represents what you would be looking for. Then look at all the approvals. Yeah, ask for the approvals. Have they got building approvals from the county government? Have they got development approval from the county government? Have the architectural plans been approved, engineering plans been approved? Do they have NEMA approval? So you look at the whole range of approvals and confirm that all of them are in place and that they have been approved accordingly.
And as well, you need to check who is providing finances for the project.
Yes, I agree, because how deep the pockets of the developer are is very key.
Yeah.
Yeah, I could tell you I'm building this nice thing here, properly designed, but at the end of the day, if I don't have the funding, then it's a problem. So there, what you do is to check that this is somebody who has a track record. if they've completed projects before, in all likelihood they could complete this one as well. So if they have a track record, then you could be dealing with a property that is likely to be completed. Now then, in your contract for purchase of the property, it should have provisions on the building of the property, how long it will take, when it will be completed, a clause requiring the developer to consult you if they want any variations done on the property. Because remember, you're buying on the basis of the plans that you saw. So if there are going to be any variations, then you should be consulted or notified that there will be variations. Yeah, so